What are pre-construction activities? In this video, I'm going to cover some activities that really need to be included in your efforts, and I would say probably put it into a checklist. I've talked about pre-construction from the builder's perspective, from the designer's perspective, from the pre-construction manager's perspective, but here are some key things that have to happen in pre-construction for you to be successful. I'm super excited to share them with you, so stay with us. Let's go ahead and do this. I'm going to go through these one by one. This might be a shorter video, but I want to explain these things and just give you a brief list. So this is kind of like our gut check video, right? Like I said, I've covered these others and you can search them on this channel from different perspectives. This is just a quick list. So let's do these one by one. Number one, project scope definition. We need to clarify what's being built and why. And if it's a development, we need to make sure that everything that we're doing matches the pro forma and hits any targets, schedule targets, budget targets. But one of the main things that we really need to do is make sure we understand the conditions of satisfaction for the owner and that the entire team, all stakeholders, are delivering on that value. Number two, site investigation. And I cannot stress this enough. When I say I can't tell you effectively how many times I've been on a project where we saw early on that we would need shoring, that there was, you know, a historical preservation investigation and process that we needed to go through, or that there was an existing utility. I remember one time there were comm lines going right through the site and nobody noticed it until we got there. And then it literally took 3 months to get it figured out. What if that was a duct bank or something that had to do with the bureaucratic electrical companies? Like, that would be a nightmare, right? So soils, unsuitables, groundwater, the need for shoring, existing utilities in the way, existing structures, historical preservation. I could just keep going on and on and on. We need to make sure that we're analyzing the site to make sure it's ready. Number three, design development. What that means is we need to help the designers get to where they need to be. And you're probably thinking, Jay Money, like, the design just happens and we just show up and build it. Well, hold on. Concept design, schematic design, maybe. But design development is key. Design development and then the construction documents. Let me tell you why. In the design development, and I've said this in other videos, we need to make sure that the designers are designing key aspects of the work for installation. We need to understand what the work package is and design to it. The other thing is, selecting the right systems with the design team and the owner will really help us when we are building. And in the constructability reviews, that's just a key component of what we're supposed to do, not only to add input for how we want to build it, but to keep us under budget. In the CD phase, we need to help the model get complete so that we can then use that for coordination. And we need to be doing checks right then and there on the drawings so we have the most complete set of drawings that we possibly can. So 100%, we need to be helping with the design. Number four, constructability reviews. This means we're pulling in VDC. This means that we have builders coming in and reviewing. This means that we're literally looking at the bottlenecks in our overall strategic plan. And like I said, designing and building it differently so that they'll go faster. This means that we're going page by page and making sure that there isn't any defects in the drawings. You might say, Jason, that's a designer's job. Yeah, sure it is. And we can complain about it all we want, but they're incentivized to do worse and worse jobs as we go forward. They want the design as cheap and fast as possible. Construction companies are being asked to participate in this. So constructability reviews and actually design document reviews is actually a part of our scope most of the time. Number five, cost estimating and budgeting. I love this. We are gonna get numbers from our trades. We are gonna get unit rates. We are gonna get cost per square foot. We are gonna look at program types. We are going to have conceptual estimates that do comps for other buildings from a historical reference class, and we're going to do internal control estimates as well. The key is we've got to get those turned around fast so we can make decisions quickly and not react to design. I remember Brian Brown at Hensel Phelps saying it's design react, he hates that. We really should design to the budget with real-time collaborative information. Number six, value engineering is not lop off parts of the design because now we can't afford it because we lost track of it. Value engineering is literally where we assess different types of designs and engineering solutions so that we can get more value for less dollars. And managing that and strategically focusing on key areas where to implement that, that's definitely a task that we have to do every project. So we're delivering, oh, I love this phrase, the highest quality and the most amount of value for the lowest overall total project cost. Number seven, scheduling and phasing. I'm telling you, we need to plan that project right from the interview. And in the schematic design portion of the project, actually concept design, schematic design, and especially by design development, we should have a macro level tack plan. We should have our procurement system up and running. We should be tracking supply chains. We need to have a great plan. And oh, here's what I really want to say. That plan should be made, reviewed three different times before we go to work on the project site and we put a shovel on the ground, 100%. Number eight, procurement planning. You cannot start early enough. Here's what the industry does wrong. We don't start early enough with procurement planning. We don't push for enough options to do an early release, either financially or with an LOI. We don't track it on a weekly basis as an art form. And we definitely don't loop in the right people. And oh, the last one, because we don't do these things, we don't see problems when they happen real time so that we can recover in the supply chain. So procurement is definitely something we have to do early and often in pre-construction. Number nine, permitting and approvals. This isn't just the building permit, which needs to be monitored 100%, but it's also all of the other permits, right? We have permits for floodplains. We have hill permits. We have permits for dust, for SWIP, for historical preservation. Oh my gosh, I'm going to bore you. But somebody needs to be tracking those permits. And even if the design team is tracking the builder permit, please stay on top of it, because it's our job to pull in the design readiness, our contracting, our coordination, and our permitting to hit at the right time so we can start that project well. And then the last thing that I would say, well, you know, there's all the typical stuff dealing with the builders and pulling the builders in to make sure that they're doing the planning. But I will say the pre-flight kickoff meeting, managing the design team to where everybody's doing well, and then kicking off the construction project with the trades, building the team as we go, are key things. Now, this video was intended to simply be a quick review of the things that we have to have. I've covered the perspectives of different entities in pre-construction in different videos. This is a quick checklist, so I want you to analyze, please, and I'll turn this into a quick little checklist in the description below. Do we have these things and are you doing them well? Actually, you could even score yourself 1 to 10 and see if you're doing them well and if you need to make any improvements. Please check out the checklist and comment below if you have any questions. We really are here to help. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.